Book we are reading today is called Miles and Miles of Reptiles. I am the cat in the hat in my crocodile car. We are off to find the reptiles wherever they are. We will find the lizards and turtles and then travel for miles to see snakes, alligators, and real crocodiles. There are thousands of reptiles. I will show some to you. Your mother will not mind at all if I do. Reptiles breathe air, mostly eggs on land. Some slither, some swim, some run on hot sand. Some reptiles have teeth, some reptiles have tails. All reptiles have skin that is covered in scales. First, let's meet some lizards. Count them and you will find more lizards than all other reptiles combined. Lizards have eyelids that open and close. Most lizards you will see on each foot have five toes. When lizards are hungry, some things that they eat are plants, insects, snails, and other type of meat. There are all kinds of lizards. Would you ever think that there is a lizard that is known as a skink? This is a glass lizard. It looks like a snake, but call it a snake and you make a mistake. The world's biggest lizard is here in our wagon. It can grow 10 feet long and it's a Komodo dragon. Reptiles are cold-blooded, but I have been told this does not mean reptiles have blood that is cold. It means that their temperature changes a lot. They get cold when it's cold. They get hot when it's hot. How do lizards get warm? Why? Thank you for asking. They lie in the sun, and that is called basking. Meet my friend, the chameleon. He is hiding right here. He changes his color when danger is near. When he is scared, he turns dark and he stays out of sight. But his colors can turn bright when he is ready to fight. A chameleon's tail has a powerful grip. It holds on to things so it won't slip. One eye can look one way while one looks the other. One eye looks at me, one looks at my brother. On the Galapagos Island, we will see something new, iguanas. They are lizards. Here's what they do. They swim in the waves, and when they are done, they crawl on the rocks and get warm in the sun. They have glands that strain salts from salt water, and then they sneeze the salt out from their noses again. These lizards are geckos. Aren't they pretty? They live in desert, rainforest, and city. They have pads on their feet that are perfect for gripping. They can climb up a wall, even glass, without slipping. Why are they named gecko? Thing one and I know. Some chirp and some squeak, and it sounds like a gecko. So come meet some snakes. When they move on the ground, their scales on their skin help them slither around. A snake's jaw is loosely attached on each side. This means it can open its mouth very wide. A snake smells with its tongue. It's showing us how it flicks in and flick out. He is smelling right now. How do snakes avoid danger so they can survive? Here are some things that help snakes stay alive. Snakes may have stripes, spots, and rings on their skin. They can hide in plain sight. Their skin helps them blend in. Some, like a vein snake, can fool you and me. It looks like a vein hanging down from the tree. If you hear a rattlesnake's tail start to rattle, it means I might bite you, so you better skedaddle. A cobra snake that is not very polite, and that's because of its poisonous bite. When it's angry, a cobra spreads out its big hood. If you see it, you will know things are not looking good. Fangs hung from its jaw and punch holes in the skin, and then a poison called venom begins to flow in. Now meet the turtles. Each one has a shell. This hard shell protects it and does so quite well. Turtles heat up in a nice sunny spot, then slide into the water when they got too hot. Turtles are toothless, so they cannot chew. They swallow food whole. That's all they can do. Here is a tortoise. I happen to know this reptile eats grass and it moves very slow. It looks like a turtle, but I understand a turtle lives in water, a tortoise on land. About the tortoise, I discovered one thing. Each year of its life, its shell grows a new ring. Turtles have four legs, but sea turtles like these have flippers to swim through the water with ease. They lay eggs on land, and each mom somehow knows which beach she was hatched on, so that's where she goes. When the babies are hatched, the shells on their backs are so soft, they are helpless if something attacks. We measure these babies. They are so very small. Their skins are just 3 inches long, and that's all. On the Florida coast, in a swamp or lagoon, you may see a crocodile swimming by soon. Crocodiles have sharp teeth, and they walk on four legs. Their feet have sharp claws. Their young hatch from eggs. There are crocs that can eat till they are filled up, and then it could be months or even years before they eat again. Alligators and crocodiles look alike, as you see. That's because they belong to the same family. We looked at them closely, and here's what we saw. The gator's teeth hung over its lower jaw, and the crocodile have upper teeth and lower teeth. They both live near water, and these reptiles glide by swimming their powerful tails side to side. If you look at their heads like we did side by side, a croc's head is thin and the gator's is wide. They mate in the water, and then we understand the female comes out to lay eggs upon land. She digs a deep nest, and then she lays her eggs in it, laying 6 days or so, about one every minute. When the babies are hatched, this is how small they are. Each one weighs as much as a thin one's candy bar. Reptiles are everywhere. Just look. You might see one down the ground or up in a tree. They come in all shapes and all colors and sizes, and you will discover they are full of surprises. The end.